No. Stop. I'm gonna make it echo through the. No. Stop. Make it echo through the. Wait, you speak since.
Shall I entrust it?
My mom checking you.
Wreck it out in your silence. Kneel before. You decided which one of you will die first. Go to hell.
I know. I know.
Don't be dumb, no. Die, ashes to ashes.
Like a terrible appearance.
Kneel before.
I turn my turn.
Out of my way.
There is a fly right next to me. And it's making me go insane.
Taking my time.
What? Okay, give me some running back. Ah, you... Dante!
Have you decided which one of you will die first? Kneel before.
Oh, you... I was about to pull a World of V. Because I had max... Oh, that hurts. That hurts me. When you're about to pull a water V, but it won't work, and ultimately you get hit as during the animation, finally. Obviously it's the first try, so... Oh my god, his attack combos are so long. Yeah. I know, I'm literally waiting there, waiting for him to finish his combo.
Yeah.
Who's that? Who's fucking with the not so bot in anime heaven? I nearly called it hentai.
Sam really likes messing around with my puppets. I don't know why.
I think I know who's another one. He deleted immediately, so we don't know who it was. You got a line. I did no coming home. And I got up in the wind.
Show me.
I know what I'm fighting for! Not to beat the game! For her! Do it for her! Do it for her! Did I just hear him say Quicksilver? Quicksilver! Virgil, I'm not Virgil, Dante, I hate you. The beat drops as soon as I die. Yeah, makes sense. They really ruined Virgil's line. Honestly. Instead of fighting Nero, which would have been actually probably an AI coding. It would probably just fuck up with the thing, because you don't know what actual devil thing he would have. Like Tomboy or Breaker, Ragtime. It would have fucked with continuity, and not continuity, just like coding. Bro, just shoot me with the laser! Yeah, I'm literally doing that! He actually just real guarded my he swapped to real god and then real guarded my judgment cut! And real revenged! You cut! Oh, that hurt me. You're wasting my time. Me and the stone that is approaching. Honestly, why should I be grinding for Sin Devil Trigger when I can just dodge and Judgment Cut his every attack? I don't care about style, well, all I care about is winning.
It just keeps balancing so you can't charge it.
Yeah, true, but it's hard for me to actually do the fucking move!
Thank you.
Okay, I just trick dodged roll revenge, thank fuck. Get away from me with rogue god, Dante. Fuck off, Dante! All I hear is, rogue god, and I start slowly walking away. Man of death, forsaken, I am dead. I'm literally, oh my god, I hated the lady's rocket launcher moves. He just shoots a fucking orbital laser at me. Yeah. It just shits an orbital laser at me! I always dodge too early. That hurts. Yeah, the jump to the back. Imagine the imagine if they kept the reboot Dante. Oh, is it where he has the black hair? Fuck you! Pathetic Dante. You think to make a fool of me. Pathetic Dante! You could do better than that! Okay. Did too early. Dante. You asshole. You asshole! You asshole! I can never do like Judgment Cut End or anything because he's always like fucking. Because I can never get my fingers in time. So you can do it without being in sin? Bloody? My last run was so good, I barely took any damage, but then I got hit with a massive fucking strut. This run's just gone completely shit.
Now
What are you angry about?
I got a 5,000
You have to use why does going into double summoning doppelganger give you massive iframes? Good trick, you asshole! Trick, you asshole.
When the summer is approved, revive.
You fucking distracted me, you cunt! Just made it. No, it was just my word of it. Okay, if you do Void Strike with, what is it, with, Yamato, the one, this, move where you slow down enemies. No, if you, when you use it on, Dante when he has Royal Guard up, walking closer to you, you can literally see it coming.
Oh,
He parries it and you see the red. Yeah, it's really easy to avoid it afterwards because you know it's coming. Like, it's so easy to react to. Oh, yeah, true, but still. That's a habit.
Nero, it's my son. Yeah, dumbass. You can't remember through that thick skull.
You cunt.
Well, well. That was a long time ago. All things.
Oh, is that all you got? Oh, little Virgil's got a bear bear. Little Virgil's got a baby. I love that.
Shall I enter?
Deal.
What makes the game impossible? It's the controls of hell. I open up Unity and the spell book in the city. For those of you who don't know, Unity Pyramids is where the game is too hard. And when that is not available, then you can put out some damage. And that is a good one. So, let's go to the future. Both of them are used to work with the digital effect of the city. And then, all of them are to stand on the game is too hard.
Oh my god, ladies having a child. Let's go!
Steven keeps trapping Timmy to get his revenge. So you went after defeating Timmy? Yes, but the game is still too easy. Otherwise, this will be clickbait. And here's where I added a feature that is not to confuse the player. You're only allowed to move in one direction at a time, left or right. Obviously, you want to move right into V2. Every 5 seconds, the direction is randomized with a chance of being left or right. If you're stuck under the leaves and you left in order to escape, control will be allowed to move right. If you see colors, the position is in the opposite direction of the game. Fix and bug are some factors that will reduce the game, which is kind of important. Outside of some awkward effects around the level, you can see the game. I have no idea what's going on earlier than outside. And here's my friend, Fingy. Moved in wrong direction and stop the team. I seem pretty confused, but even in this hour, I'm too happy. People just forced to move in the wrong direction and let them in the wrong direction. That's okay, this game is still free. Covering this episode, I'm happy to play so much. So this is 30 seconds time for end, so be soon. I think this game has extra light out without me down. And yeah, I think this is wrong.
It's been known for quite a while now that me and Dante Ravioli have a bit of a rivalry. Between speedrun races, randomized races, and challenge runs, Dante and I have been competing with each other in an epic gaming conquest for quite a while now. After all of these hard-fought battles, though, Dante and I have decided to make love, not war. Wait, what? What I meant to say is that we have finally stopped fighting and we're teaming up to take on our greatest challenge yet. Teamwork. If you take the combined efforts of two god gamers and apply it to a single cooperative speedrun, who knows what sort of chaos will unfold? Today, I intend to find out, as Dante and I are attempting to learn the Resident Evil 5 co-op speedrun. You can say that I have some experience when it comes to Resident Evil speedruns, but I've never done a run of Resident Evil 5. I have a combined 4,000 hours of Resident Evil games across Steam, and I've only ever played RE5 but once on an E8. The E8 would be one for the ages, though. And after a first hour of this one, it already lasted longer than the other did. Just aside, I've played Resident Evil 5 a few dozen times back in the day on Couch Co-op, and even at times viewed the game in one sitting. But never been a proper speedrun of it.
You dare
it's a relatively short game with a tight speed construction that makes it cool to let them run. We will be attempting to learn a new game amateur co-op speedrun, which currently has a world record of 1 hour and 18 minutes by McGalligan and Curtis. I know what you're saying, but waifu, that's baby mode.
Let me jog your memory.
Why do you play on the professional difficulty since you adopt your professional gamers? Hush, my child.
Because mommy
that's
got
rich. Speedrunning is about speed. We're trying to go fast, not do right. And if your city sets to elevate an alternative sexual archetype, aka fastest Sheva. But no, I found what the least fun thing I've ever done in my life, so we're sticking to amateur. Right from the start, I knew I had to Chris, as Dante has a much more time talking with Sheva recently. Here was his real test skill, though.
You're probably right.
Boss fight. We're all good, I was feeling pretty confident.
Wait, can you. Can you only chain judgment cuts with only perfect?
My god, dude. So there is synergy would be a great asset to the team. Well, I will be going to the gym and an absolute beefcake like Chris. It's important for co-op partners to have good synergy and compatibility with their characters. Now, in order to learn.
No, like, you can obviously, but like. What is it? Obviously you can, but can you only do it with that? Or can you do it with like the normal judgment cut?
Dante and myself are just getting used to the controls and learning exactly where to go and who goes first. Co-op speedruns are all about delegation. Each team member knowing at the time what they are supposed to do, and so you can divide and conquer the level. Teamwork. Team members managing inventory while waiting for others to reach stores or grabbing items.
Oh, I'm getting off the double chain. I'm practicing.
Unlike RE4, though, this one is just on a timer. There is an executioner that chases around here. Once he opens the gate, we run and grab the machine gun and a ton of grenades. Then I run up into this corner and have him trapped underneath the balcony while Dante runs around and grabs.
So in the air, it's easier. Why didn't you tell me, buddy?
The executioner and steal his lunch money. After a bit of cyberbullying, he drops a free treasure that we'll need for later. I go down really easy, just two headshots that stuns him, then you knife him a little bit, and then
he
rolls and beat his ass.
Yeah, you didn't tell me that before.
He goes down. We just have to wait for the helicopter to come and save us. absolutely nailed this first chapter and head into the next one. It's all fun and games running from Bob and Young at each other in a hurry.
You can do Judgment Cut without needing fucking Sin Double Trigger. No one ever told me that!
This team having two IPs, Ouroboros is four times super effective. Thankfully, Dante is a master technical handler and gets him right into the fire trap on the first try. The collaboration is going super smoothly, and me and Dante both skim the tutorials ahead of time, so we know at least the early game pretty well. Late game, we don't know that much, as we haven't been able to watch that far into the tutorial yet. The cracks in our knowledge starts to show a little bit as the ravioli bandito itself run into a wider array of enemy types. Dogs, explosives, and even trucks. Our unfamiliarity with the game's movement especially causes us to be out of sync quite a bit. I get lost and lose Dante a little bit, but once we regroup at the fence, it's all good. This is where Dante is supposed to shoot two barrels to kill the truck as it runs at us. Then he goes on to shoot the last barrel to kill some enemies, but I rushed ahead too fast and got my ass exploded.
Oh no.
You shot it once and it didn't blow?
I didn't.
This is when I learned that I was in fact the one that let the dogs out.
Let the dogs out!
It was me! As I run ahead, Dante shoots the locks in front of me so I can open the doors immediately as I get to them. We push people aside and run towards the next section.
I just pushed that guy over!
What a boy.
He just fell over.
This is where I show off my 6 CSGO skills and throw a few grenades. First, over the corner to kill as many enemies as possible, then over the building to try and break a lock on the other side of the door from over the top.
Wait, what happens if you use overdrive on him?
Top of the building and throw a shotgun across. Now all you have to do is open the door and kill the
but like, probably not much, but how stunt. Is that the only move that you can do to him? But once you finally get out of it, it will finally launch him out.
Technically faster to just run through this section in the dark, we have to have me hold the light for Dante so he can actually see where he's going. It's not much slower. He has faith in me, but I have lost faith in my ability to navigate this game's controls, and I can't figure out how to drop the goddamn light.
Oh god,
drop it! Oh, drop it!
I had faith in you, I did!
Oh, there we go. Once we leave the mines, I grab the sniper and I can protect Dante.
For extra DPS, just put the blades around you. It's fucking annoying.
A lot of the routing comes from grabbing treasures and selling them in late game to buy rocket launchers for the bosses. In early game, though, we just have to kill the bosses legit. But not before a little bit of cheating. Here we do a trick called a tactical reset, where Dante runs ahead and hits the checkpoint trigger while I am collecting treasures and ammo far away. Then I can reload checkpoint to teleport myself to him, saving a lot of traversal time. Right before the boss, Dante sells his pistol and starts baiting the new machine gun. He also upgrades out the bad boss with the dumper, we kill the boss nearly instantly with our superior teamwork. Well, we would have if I had not missed the sniper aim up earlier. Thankfully, we still kill him really quickly and only get the chance to do basic anything. Next, we hit up Tokyo Drift in this awesome auto scroller. Man, I love RE5, but this section is so 2010s it's painful. I don't know why this era was obsessed with driving sections and turret sections. I get it, cars are cool, but I drive an automatic and drive exclusively to the supermarket and back. I don't really need a turret driving section in my game. Thankfully, this trend has died, but now it's replaced by Walk and Talk, so honestly, I'm not sure what I like less. At the end of the long road, we get to the Gigante boss fight. Me and Dante start blasting. I actually troll a little bit here and shot the barrels before I was supposed to. You're supposed to save those from when he sets up the telephone pole. Besides that, you just tank all of his hits and then try to kill him before you die. We couldn't quite do that because if we did, we would have died for sure. It was a little terrifying.
Okay, I'm not
gonna die. Yeah, I felt like we'll die if we did it by that one. We'll die if we did it again. This concludes the first third of the game. In classic speedrun fashion, though, we decided that it would be good to practice it, so we started over from the beginning and ran through the whole game up to the gigantic fight once again. The first village holdout was way more scuffed this time around, and also gets to add to the heat by the execution a few times. It doesn't actually move any times, this section is
there we go, I got the triple off! No, I can't do it again. So how did you do it, buddy? Just the chain judgment.
Now that we're in the swamps of Florida, we're on our way to Florida to collect three medallion pieces to open
the door,
not before I drive into every possible wall in the left. I got everything all the best driver. We'll figure it out, but...
Fuck, I'm never landing this. Holy shit. She aims the thing at you. Yeah.
Put out the castle, you can teleport after dropping the medallion. The pizza sections fly by. After this, we have a few puzzles that you have to solve. You get to move these lasers and have some reflectors in the right spots. However, the lasers will absolutely blast your teammates. So you have to make sure that everyone is in position so they don't get fired. At the start of the next chapter, I buy another rocket launcher from the boss and get an extra level of health. This section of the game is all about guarding your teammate while they open the doors. First door, Dante guards me, and then at the elevator, I guard Dante with the new launcher.
You think to make a fool. Your nightmare
is the boss, you jump over the wall. Legend, and then the second time, I just missed for the boss. One time more, thank you. Third, I actually hit the boss, instant killing him. Then we buy a few rocket launchers and some blast grenades. The rest of the game, the enemy will have guns. Apparently, that's something that happens in Resident Evil now. I blame all your four. The best strategies for these sections is to just flash them like you're in Mardi Gras and walk deep, more than you want yourself to check. The flash grenades aren't very useful in the quickest though, so we just run past those. The next big room has a lot of enemies in it, so you can actually forgive some of them from being under the We're using eye contact to a minimum is not only more comfortable, but also fast. Walking backwards like this gets some of the enemies in the section. From here, we just run past some insects and to the end of the level, where I was supposed to pick up some fire rounds from these barrels, but I completely forgot, and we head right into a reverse boss fight. And with another rocket, Dante blasts the hentai right out of his breath. The next room is full of flashes as Dante and myself run past many gun enemies and giant cockroaches. I send them across the gondola and then set to despawn the enemies. Once across, there are two Plaga enemies I have to finish off with the flash grenades. Then we ride a big, spinning elevator of doom, or boredom, I guess. I load my explosive rounds into my inventory, and then we head into the next room where Dante will defend me from endless force flickers while I push a big box to unlock the bridge. Now we arrive at the Lester fight. 7 minutes. 7 minutes is all I can spare. What the fuck?
Well, for some reason, I don't have... no, wait, because I have... I probably didn't install all of it. The Mega Buster and Monkey Business. What the f... I'm just looking through this. For some reason, I don't have, like, the different announcer.
Stop.
Neuro doesn't get Sin Devil Trigger shit game. And DMC6, he'll get it. Just sometime during a mission get Sin Devil Trigger. Like some Whoopty Fork can do bullshit. Like attempted suicide. Because that's how everyone gets power in the game, don't they? Attempted suicide. No, just give him Sin Devil Trigger in DMC6 by make him do attempted suicide for power. This is inside me. Why is Silver Bullet not a soundtrack you can listen to? Yeah. Wait a minute. Does you know like a you know how Doom has their own book?
Oh.
Damn it.